When we first came to know and love Jason Biggs, thanks to his memorable big screen debut in American Pie.
And now the New Jersey native is starring in the highly anticipated Netflix series, Orange is the New Black. Take a look.
I think I might want it.
My mighty staff. Piper, there is no it yet.
I know, but if there is...
You're going to prison in 3 months.
I know, I could be pregnant while I'm in prison. What else am I going to be doing in there?
How did we go from not talking about kids at all to starting a prison family?
Let's talk about being complicated. All right, well, Jason is here live.
Wow.
Welcome back.
Thank you. Nice to see you guys again.
Good to see you.
Too.
Good to see you. Congratulations. That's getting great buzz already.
Yeah, it's I'm really proud of it. It's really a cool show and
tell me a little bit about the premise of the show.
Well, the premise, it's based on a true story. So Piper Kerman, it's based on her experience. She went to prison for 15 months, federal prison, for her involvement in a drug running ring. And, you know, it was something that she had done when she was younger, and 10 years had gone by. And before the statute of limitations expired, she was ratted out and went to prison. And so it's kind of... you know, just kind of just a regular, you know, we're a yuppie couple living in Brooklyn, and then and I didn't know about it, and then all of a sudden she's off to live with this interesting cast of characters in a women's prison upstate New York.
So, wow, and you play her fiance in the movie. How'd you get ready for this role? I mean, since it's based on a true story, what kind of research did you do?
You know, none.
You just read the script.
Yeah. I was going to pretend that I was a true professional for a minute, but no research. What is that? I don't know. I show up, I read lines. Is there something else to do? But actually, to that end, it really, you know, it was adapted by Jenji Kohan, who did Weeds.
Of course.
And she's just so incredibly talented. And, you know, it really was all there on the page. There really wasn't much research I needed to do. I mean, my character's dilemma, his conflict, is all pretty obvious. His fiance is, and he didn't know about this. So there's lies involved, you know, and hidden truths. So he's separated from the love of his life, and he's ultimately a victim in all of this as well. So
let's talk too about the women that are on the show. You have such a great cast of women. It's Jenji Kohan, like you said.
Yep.
It's Natasha Lyonne, who you were with before.
Natasha,
And Taylor
Schilling,
who was on A Lucky One.
Laura Prepon.
So having so many great women around, is it kind of female driven? Around there?
Oh, yeah. No, it's definitely a, I'm the odd man out.
Yeah.
Literally, man out. It's, but you know, I grew up with two sisters, and, you
so
know,
you're,
it's
you're,
a,
you're
oh, yeah, no, I get it. Yeah. But it's fun being kind of one of the few guys in the show, you know? But all these
less
women.
Less competition.
Less competition, exactly.
And all these great women.
Yeah, and I'm barely a man, you know? So it's
good to know.
Yeah.
We'll
yeah.
tweet that.
Yeah, but it's, it's an amazing cast, and they're all incredible.
And it's filmed mostly in New York City, Brooklyn, Rockland County.
That's right.
Do you like working on the East Coast?
It's my favorite place to be.
Get to see your family.
Yep, get to see my family, and they're all in Jersey still. And
do you get to go home often when you're?
I do.
Yeah.
Well, I was here for 6 months doing the first season, you know, so there were plenty of opportunities to see them. I was here through the holidays, and so.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it was nice.
Well, I want to just mention quickly how you've had. I read your Twitter. It's so funny. And
thank you.
You've recently gotten a Amanda Bynes. Spat.
What was that all about? Why go there?
Well,
did you think
when she writes something like this, you get turned on, but what you are not by what you're not.
Yes.
So
you can't ignore that.
It's kind of she's lobbing me a grapefruit there. It's kind of hard not to. I just you know, and I kind of yeah. So I was just so easy, and so but now and then she like got wrote back at me, but like even the sort of the responses were just nonsensical.
And it's just want to just give
it's
her
just,
a hug.
It's just kind of clear.
On.
That's the thing. No, it's just kind of clear that
give her a Twitter hug.
I know.
Give her a Twitter hug.
I don't know if I'm gonna go that far to give her a Twitter hug, but I may stop.
Yes.
Leave her alone.
I may just leave her alone.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, but she clearly, you know, I think needs some more love.
She needs some guidance.
She needs a little guidance.
You just did the 24-hour plays.
Yep.
I know you've done a significant amount of Broadway. I love seeing you on stage. Are we going to see you back in New
York?
We're
old stage cohorts.
We are. We were going to play next to each other
in
the same
place. That's right. We were neighbors. I love doing it. I mean, you know, there's nothing like it.
I know.
Like the best, the live audience, and especially here in New York, it's the place to do it.
The place to do it.
And so, yes, so I'm always reading scripts and auditioning always looking for the next opportunity to get back
on stage. You've been doing this for a long time, too. So you were 13 years old. This is you. I love this.
How cute is this?
Oh, wow. Yeah. That's from the playbill for Conversations with My Father, my first Broadway show.
And somebody else in that show you just reunited with
for the 24-hour play.
David Krumholtz. Yeah, David Krumholtz and I. This was David's first professional acting job.
And it was not yours?
It was not mine. At this point, I was like a veteran. No. I was a seasoned vet at this point. I had been doing it for many, many years. In fact, at that point, was considering retiring.
Is that Fred Savage in there, too?
That was Fred Savage who directed. So for the 24-hour play, so those who don't know, it's an amazing thing. It's six writers, six directors, 24 actors get together. They get together on Friday night. They all meet, share a prop, share a costume, share a little story, a tidbit, whatever. The writers stay overnight, write short plays with the actors in mind. We come back in the morning with the directors. The directors get paired up to scripts. Then the actors get paired up, and we have all day to rehearse and perform it that night.
So
the whole thing is 24 hours. We do it on Broadway. We do it in L.A.
We had Rosie Perez on to talk about it when they did it in New York.
Fred, I did it. I've done it in New York. It's great. So Fred directed David and it was great.
Oh,
nice.
That's fun. All right. Well, you can catch Jason in Orange is the New Black when it premieres on Netflix on July 11th and hopefully on Broadway again sometime soon.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for stopping by.
Thank you, Sarah. Thank you so much. Nice to see you guys again.
Twitter hug, Amanda Bynes.
All right. Maybe.